Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Welcome to our worship this morning. This is the fifth Sunday after the Epiphany. Good to have all of you that are with us today in the building, as well as all of you who are watching for our live stream of worship service. Good to have us connected at the family of Christ again. Our order of service and hymns are all on the PowerPoint, as well as our bulletin, which is available again on our website, christlutheransc.ca. If you want to download the PDF and follow along at home. Let us join our voices together for our first hymn, Song of Thankfulness and Praise, and let us rise.
Stand.
But with you there is forgiveness.
Therefore you are feared. Confess to you all my sins and iniquities, with which I have ever offended you, and justly deserve your punishment, now and forever. But I am heartily sorry for them, and sincerely repent of them, and I pray you of your boundless mercy, and for the sake of the holy, innocent, bitter sufferings and death of your beloved Son, Jesus Christ, to be gracious and merciful to me, a poor, sinful being.
Upon this your confession, I, by virtue of my office as a called and ordained servant of the word, announce the grace of God to all of you. And in the stead and by the command of my Lord Jesus Christ, I forgive you all of your sins. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
We sing, the Lord have mercy.
Have mercy on us.
also with you.
Let us pray. Holy God, gracious Father, you sent your only Son as the word of life for our eyes to see and our ears to hear. Help us to believe with joy what the Scriptures proclaim. We ask this through Jesus Christ, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen.
Thank you.
The Holy Gospel, according to St. Mark, chapter 1, verses 29 to 39.
Glory to you, O Lord.
As soon as Jesus and the disciples left the synagogue, they entered the house of Simon and Andrew with James and John. Now Simon's mother-in-law was in bed with a fever, and they told him about her at once. He came and took her by the hand and lifted her up. Then the fever left her, and she began to serve them. That evening at sunset, they brought to him all who were sick or possessed with demons, and the whole city was gathered around the door. And he cured many who were sick with various diseases, and cast out many demons. And he would not permit the demons to speak, because they knew him. In the morning, while it was still very dark, he got up and went out to a deserted place, and there he prayed. And Simon and his companions hunted for him. When they found him, they said to him, "Everyone is searching for you." He answered, "Let us go on to the neighboring towns, so that I may proclaim the message there also, for that is what I came out to do." And he went throughout Galilee, proclaiming the message in their synagogues and casting out demons. This is the gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, O Christ.
I believe in God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. The third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and sits at the right hand of God, the Father Almighty. From thence he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Christian Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen.
You may be seated for our sermon hymn, O God of Mercy, God of Life. Be all things to all people. Meet them where they're at. watch, learn, feel a need, assimilate, influence. This used to be a very common vision, statement, and understanding for most of Christian missionary work in the world. But we also know what this phrase means within human relationships. It often goes against what we've all been taught and learned since childhood. Voices say to us, be yourself. Or, you can't please everyone, so you might as well please yourself. Carve your own pathway. Cast a vision and set it. So actually putting into practice the idea of being all things to all people seems even more strenuous now, where the fabric of our culture, at least where social media is concerned, is pulling people in all different polar opposite directions. They force us to take a side, support one position, can't deviate or change or evolve. Having people get along is now viewed suspiciously, even negatively. We're somewhat skeptical of people even trying to be all things to all people. Maybe we call them copycats or keeners, or there's even more colorful words for that. We don't readily trust it. We assume there must be a hidden agenda. And yet musicians and entertainers often comment that copying is the highest form of flattery. Many a church committee over the years, I'm sure, has said, we just can't be expected to be all things to all people. And that is a little bit true, too, especially when we talk about programming and attempting to please too many people in too many ways. But we can make efforts in offering a sincere, wide welcome. Taking the initiative, cordially inviting people you know and people you don't know into the community of faith and life in the Lord's church. This does no harm, and in fact, extends the hand of fellowship and community, because we need community. And real community comes only through our oneness in Jesus Christ. For we are the body of Christ in the world. Jesus makes us into followers, so that we may be all things to all people. That's what Apostle Paul is teaching us today. And why? Why does Paul take the time to be like a Jew or a Gentile? Why? To win over as many for the sake of the gospel. And the gospel is Jesus' saving life, death, and resurrection for all people. This is the message we, the body of Christ, as the church, take to heart and emulate and copy in our daily living. This doesn't mean the church must always buy into numerous quick fix programs or to jumpstart fast-paced membership or keep a church needlessly focused on busyness or entertain every complaint or wish. It's not about that. Certainly ideas and visions and initiatives can create renewed energy and interest, but it is the gospel that is always our spirit-led inspiration. This will keep us from letting our prejudices or our fears or our egos get in the way from winning over all people you encounter into God's kingdom of grace. It involves using all of our God-given talents to build bridges with all those outside or even within the church who need Jesus' saving word of hope. Forgiveness and mercy are too valuable. Heaven is too important. Eternity is a long time for anyone to spend apart from God. Jesus Christ desires all to be saved and come to the knowledge of the truth. You have been given the truth. I have been given the truth. And together we truly and authentically can be all things to all people, to win over as many people for the sake of the gospel. Sometimes you may find when you work with maybe difficult people or those who seem difficult, maybe when you butt heads with them a time or two, there's a tactic which can work and often works. If you come up alongside that person in discussions, you listen, you agree with the agreeable points, and then when getting in the areas of disagreement and by validating the points of truth and agreement, soon the disagreeing areas begin to fade into mutual understanding. Maybe both parties begin listening and coming to an understanding of where the other comes from. Maybe then you begin to come into the middle of the road, into the area of greater growth, and continue walking together. My counseling friends always call you can't necessarily point to a scripture passage or a Lutheran teaching that talks about this kind of method. It's more about common listening and learning, growing, finding agreement areas, establishing relationships before ironing out all the areas of difference. Trying to speak the truth in love, to be all things to all people, to win over as many people. Usually works, but slowly we also begin winning over a brother or a sister, and not to become prideful of ourselves, for we are also in turn kind of being won over ourselves. Apostle Paul knew the city of Corinth well, and the church he developed. Religion and culture and social graces and politics all kind of flowed together in Greek life. Paul needed to know his audience, engage the world around him if he had any hope of winning over the men and women into the Christian faith. It is hard work. It is slow work. It's much easier in church work to build a fortress around yourself. Sit and watch for the next one who's going to take a shot against your wall. Being on the defensive. Succumb to fears. Always looking for what problem will happen next. That last shoe to drop. And as you do that, the God-given trust in Christ begins slipping away. And satanic forces are there to chip away, and you begin to feel even more isolated as Christians. And then it's so much easier positioning oneself into, I'm right, everyone else is wrong. It's not healthy. It's not Christ-like. And in our own ways, we do that too in our own lives. It's a sinful pattern which also the world emulates. We are in the world. We are never of the world. All being things to all people is not becoming like the world. That's the worry other Christians have too. That will start to do as they do. But in truly winning over others into God's kingdom for Jesus' sake is taking the living Christ who lives in us into the community, willingly putting ourselves out there to be instruments of his peace. Christ comes to you by grace. It is a priceless gift, and it sets you free. And that freedom is for sharing in loving others. Sharing that grace of Christ where you do have rights, but with those rights in Christian freedom comes the responsibility as we are one with each other. Tied to each other like yarn in a skein. For around you today even sits a brother or a sister for whom Christ has died and into whose life he dwells so richly. And out of your Christ-like love, you may occasionally give up some of those rights. Because the Christian life, in the end of the day, is not just about us or you or me. The Apostle Paul gives examples of how he's given up his rights in order to serve the Corinthians. Earlier in the chapter, he says he doesn't eat and drink always what he wants. He put aside any interest in finding a wife. And not to be holier than thou, but anything that became a stumbling block for him, and for the spirit-filled ability to share the gospel and win over people he passed aside. Why, he even proclaimed in the book of Acts a sermon addressed to an unknown God of a pagan temple. For his true God, the true God, Jesus Christ, he said, is their unknown God. They just don't know it yet. To win over a pagan people. All things to all people. About 5 years ago, when I received an invitation to sit at the head table of a synagogue's interfaith clergy luncheon, and their synagogue sat across the street from the church I served in Winnipeg, I didn't refuse, and I wasn't offended that I needed to wear that yarmulke on my head like all the other men in attendance. And not only was I given a place of honor with them, but I was even asked to share my faith in Christ, and it was received with respect and joy. This faith we share in Christ can't ever be a personal achievement either. That's the temptation. We like to take credit for a job well done. We forget that we too have that illness of sin found deeply in the core of who we are. You and I can't be who God calls us to be of our own will. We would really rather be nothing to nobody, just live unto our own desires, just be myself. And no matter how hard we try to hide it, to pass ourselves off as better people, we'll always be fallen and imperfect. And so, with that truth in mind, we can't be all things to all people on our own. We'll either run the risk of seeing it as impossible or fix the outward things that look important and hide the rest. We need complete renovation and renewal. We need to face the
with healing comes regeneration,
which leads to the spiritual exercise of our faith that we may keep growing and keep getting stronger in faith and we run this race together. Our spiritual diet for renewal is God's word and sacraments. Our spiritual exercise is scripture reading, praying, listening, helping, communing, remembering the Lord's goodness. That begins in our baptismal font where our identity and journey of life begins. Our pathway always starts in Jesus Christ as he comes to us. Paul isn't telling the Corinthians, oh, just turn into another Paul. Be trained in the law like me, travel where you want, don't marry a spouse. No, Paul isn't saying that at all. He does say, imitate me. Learn from my leading. To an outsider, be as an outsider. To win them over to the Lord's kingdom. To a doubter, be as a doubter. To win them over into the joy of comfort and hope. Don't let your freedom get in the way of sharing the gospel. For that light of Christ shining through your life will be the first thing people see when you walk among them. Treasure that freedom, that forgiveness, that peace. Christ won it for you by dying. He paid the price sin and death caused on a cross alone. Being one who dies for all. No one is left out of Jesus' all-encompassing death. His blood has been shed for all. We live, we die, we rise anew in him. Jesus forgave adulterers, murderers, extortioners, liars, even those who crucified him. He healed the religiously unclean and every no-good villain that there was. So as Jesus' brothers and sisters baptized into his life, his love, his mission, we can and are now all things and all people. Not for our sake, or to feel better about ourselves, but to pass on that treasure of freedom in Christ that you and I hold so dear. Imitating, copying, learning, and being all things will get easier. And our hope is that through us, more generations will become even more imitators with us. Followers of Christ, like mentoring, being there for them when they need us, all for the sake of the gospel of Christ. You are loved. Love does no harm to our neighbor. And God's grace equips you with everything good to do his perfect will. Christ didn't come to find the righteous. He comes to create the righteous. He has done all that for you, and by grace and peace you can be all things to all people. Little copies of Christ for the gospel's sake. Amen. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. And now may the peace of God, which goes beyond our human understanding, guard our hearts and lives in the one true faith in Jesus Christ, now and always. Let us now rise for the prayer of the church. Thank you, Lord God, for your constant saving presence with us in your holy word and sacrament. Cast out all spiritual complacency and protect us from the devil and his cunning ways. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Give grace and peace to the people of our church, her pastors and bishops, and bless the faithful members of our congregation. Cast out all false teaching and practice, so that we may grow in Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Give good and merciful government to all nations. Bring safe and peaceful resolution to the areas of our world where there is tension and unrest. Cast out oppressive tyrannical rulers and protect people from abuse of power. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Thank you for the good and peaceful government we enjoy in Canada. Give wisdom and right action to our Prime Minister, Premier, and all members of cast out hatred and division, and protect our servicemen and women who are overseas. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Have mercy, Lord, on people oppressed by demons or yielding themselves to any evil. Cast out the devil from every potential foothold in our lives and in society as a whole, so that he may never find a home among us. Turn people from dabbling in the occult and defend us from a faithless fear of the devil and his demons. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Lord, our days are in your hands and we are glad. Comfort those who mourn the loss of loved ones. Cast out all fear from us and protect us in the night of sorrow. And be with others known to us in need and whom we now name before you. Eric and Deanna Halbrecht, Eric Hawkins, Clyde and Josie Noel, Jeff Noel, Bernard McBride, Jane and Jim Baxter, Mona Barton, John Redman, Colleen Honey, Lois Johnson, Lorraine Bogusak, Emily Lisco, Grace McDermott, Marilyn Tudor. Be with all students and teachers returning to in-building class this week at our school and our community. Be with all those struggling with COVID. Be with all those who deal with depression or isolation or fears in this time of lockdown. Be with all those making decisions about the lockdown, that the good of our communities and the good of all that you give us, dear Father, will be in their mind that they make the decision moving forward. And be with all those now leaning silently in our hearts before you. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Lord, you are abundant in power, and your understanding is beyond measure. Since you have lifted us up to share life with you, keep us in the faith of Jesus Christ, and hear the prayer we offer in his name, for he lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen.
Our Father, who art in heaven,
hallowed be thy name.
Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face shine on you and be gracious to you. The Lord look upon you with favor and give you peace.
Amen.
We close with our last hymn, Here I Am, Lord.
Oh.
As I mentioned earlier, the website christlutheransc.ca, please check that out for any information, updates, and all the information as the weeks and months progress of the news and the workings and the offerings that Christ Lutheran is giving as far as activities and up-to-date information. Please check that out. And thank you also for following us on our Facebook page and also for updating a lot of our information. Let us go in forth in peace and joy, serving our Lord.
Thanks be to God.